Cubase 10.5 update, MuLab 8.3, Wave Factory cassette, free plugins, and more. Welcome to the Home Studio Show on Simple Green Tech. I'm Zane, and on this show, I do news and reviews of audio software like plugins and digital audio workstations. I also check out at least one free plugin in every episode, and I try to do an audio tip or a motivational tip in every episode. And something new I'm starting this week is I'm going to ask you a trivia question, and if you answer it correctly, I'll give you a shout out in the next video and podcast. Which reminds me, you can also download this as a podcast from thehomestudioshow.com. But right now, let's get into this week's episode. So first up in news, we have Cubase 10.5. This update provides new features and enhancements. In the Pro Edition, you'll get the Spectral Comparison EQ. This allows you to route two tracks to the same EQ, and you can compare the spectral curves in the display, which will help you to see where you need to do some tweaks. In the Pro, Artist, and Elements version, you get Video Export Render. So if you're working on scoring a video, you can now render the video with audio into an MP4 file. In the Pro and Artist versions, you get the new multi-tap delay effect. Also, Pro and Artist users get the updated PadShop synth. PadShop 2 includes many upgrades, including 100 new presets to get you started. And in all versions, you get the colorized mixer channel, which changes the color of the mixer channel to match the track. There are 10 other main updates in Cubase 10.5. I've linked to their site in the description below, so you can easily click on that in case you want more information on this great digital audio workstation. Next up in audio news, we have another DAW or digital audio workstation. MuLab has updated to version 8.3. This release addresses several fixes and improvements, plus adds some new features. Nothing too major here. You've got event mutes that let you mute individual events. And with the new multi-point envelope module, you can control the global level parameter that lets you automate and modulate the overall output level of a looped envelope. And another new feature is in the Windows 32-bit version. You get the Convert Rex Files function, which converts all Rex files in a folder to standard WAV files, which also include the Rex slice marks. MuLab is a very easy to use digital audio workstation with some great features. I'll link to my review of MuLab 8 in the description below. And now in audio interface news, Motu has released the M2 and M4 USB audio interfaces. They're compatible with Mac, Windows, and iOS. The M2 and M4 claim to offer the best-in-class audio quality, best-in-class speed, meaning low latency, and best-in-class metering with a full-color LCD. And you get all of the features that you would expect from a modern audio interface like 48-volt phantom power, plus MIDI I/O, and loopback driver channels for live streaming and podcasting. I've linked to the Motu website so you can check them out in more detail. The final piece of audio news in this episode is from the company Waves Factory, and they've released an audio plugin called Cassette. This emulates vintage cassette tapes and cassette tape decks, so you can get that vintage recording sound of a cassette tape. If you're old enough, you'll remember the days of ghetto blasters and winding your tapes up with a pencil after your tape deck ate it. And yep, this plugin emulates all of that great stuff with many options. You can choose from a few different tape decks, from pro quality to tiny portable tape players. You can also change the actual tapes that you want to use. And each tape and each deck affects the sound of your signal. This plugin may sound like something that you might want to avoid, but you can use this in a really creative and fun way to take your tracks to another level. If you're liking this episode of the Home Studio Show so far, please give it a thumbs up if you're watching it on YouTube. I really appreciate it. Now we're going to move on to the plugins worth checking out section. And we talked about it earlier. I'm going to check out Waves Factory Cassette. This is a great saturation plugin that can really add some interest to your tracks. Whether you're just using it in the intro of your song or in the bridge, or maybe you want to use it on a specific instrument through the entire track, Waves Factory Cassette will give you a sound that separates you from all of the digital music being created nowadays. So let's give it a quick listen. Here it is on a drum track. Now here it is on a synth track. And now here it is on an entire mix. Let me know what you think of Waves Factory Cassette. If you already have it or are thinking of getting it, what do you plan on using it on? At the time of recording this video, Waves Factory Cassette is actually on sale at Plugin Boutique. I've linked to them in the description below. Next up in plugins worth checking out, I have Sonovox Twist. This is a spectral morphing synthesis instrument from Sonovox. It combines a dynamic interface, an advanced pattern generator, and onboard effects with some time-saving controls. Two swirling sound layers provide unique harmonic controls, forming the foundation for every patch. Common elements include a monstrous multi-mode filter, independent amp and filter envelope generators, plus a remarkable LFO that can be synced to the current tempo. The on-screen interface is clean and uncluttered. The well-defined controls deliver incredible sound sculpting abilities while providing immediate audio results. Now let's give some of the presets a quick listen. This is actually a pretty cool instrument. Let me know what you think of it in the comments below. Also, you can let me know of any plugins, effects, or instruments that I should check out in future episodes. I really want you to be a part of this show as well. All right, before I get into the free plugin section of the show, I've got that new feature, which is the trivia section. I'm going to ask you a question, and the first 10 people to answer it before I release the next episode will get a shout out in the next episode. So here's the question. Name the song and the original artist or band from these lyrics. In a trap, trip I can't grip, never thought I'd be the one who'd slip. So let me know if you know the song and band or artist in the comments below. Now it's time to move on to the free plugin section. First up is a free plugin from Reflect Audio. This one's called Xylowood. This is a free VST and AU instrument plugin for macOS and Windows. It's based on a real authentic wooden xylophone that's located at a local museum wherever the Reflect Audio people live. And here's a sample of Xylowood. I've linked to the Reflect Audio website in the description below, so you can head over there and grab that free plugin if you like. Next up is a free EQ plugin that I've mentioned in some videos before, but they just recently updated it, and this one is Tokyo Don Labs Slick EQ. They've added VST3 support, and if you're on a Mac, they added Catalina compatibility. This update enhances both the free version and the paid version with 3 UI scales, 0 latency modes, and several bug fixes. If you go with the paid version, which is Slick EQ GE, this update comes with deep functionality updates, a new smart operations panel, a special dual mono mode imposing randomized tolerance similar to real-world electronics, and a new saturation mode. I use Slick EQ on pretty much every video that I create, so let's listen to some examples of it. Here it is on a synth track. Now I'll show you how I use it on my voice. This is a recording of my voice demonstrating the Slick EQ plugin. This has not been edited. If you know of a free plugin that I should check out in a future episode, please let me know in the comments. I want this show to be for you, so let me know what you want to see. Now we're going to move on to the audio tip, and this week it's more of a motivational tip. If you're struggling to find some inspiration for a new song, download a new instrument or effect plugin and then start playing around with it. You may just discover a new riff or idea for a new song. I actually get inspiration from using free or very cheap plugins and gear. The idea of using very inexpensive gear to make music really inspires me for some reason. Let me know what inspires you. And thank you for checking out this episode of The Home Studio Show. Remember, you can download the audio podcast from thehomestudioshow.com. Click up here to see the Home Studio Show playlist, or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you'd like to see more episodes of The Home Studio Show, please subscribe to the channel. Also, give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed this episode. For Simple Green Tech and The Home Studio Show, I'm Zane, and we'll talk soon.